Hello friends, this is Rahul here as a Chief Executive Officer of Treasury Consulting LLP, and today we would be covering a video which is another part of this video, which would be credit support annex in the bank CSA. We already had a word about CSA and why CSA is very much applicable in nature, because credit support annex is right now is one of the hottest documents as far as the regulatory is concerned. And the regulatory forum like ISDA, which is International Swap and Derivative Association, is paying a very good attention to CSA. Of course, there are a lot of amendments which are happening in the CSA, and there are a lot of flaws also which are getting corrected in the CSA as well. Now, here we are talking about the interbank CSA, and here we are taking an example of a company who already have a one-sided CSA with the bank. We are talking about the few companies who are the best known IT companies, IT and ITS companies. Example, Cognizant, TCS, SL Technologies, Wipro, Genpact, WNS and Microsoft. But out of these, they all are well known IT and ITS companies in India. But out of them, we have one company who is having one side CSA with the bank. And the name of the company is Cognizant Technologies Limited. Cognizant annually is having a portfolio, annually sale for Cognizant is roughly $19 billion. And they hedge aggressively. It is the only company which is taking care of the 7-year hedging program, whereby they will not only doing cash flow hedging, they are also taking fair value hedging. They also taking care of net investment hedging. Plus, they are hedging the same using forwards, options and swaps. All the three. Predominantly, they hedge using forwards, options and swaps. They are not using very often, but it is not that it is not a part of their portfolio. They are using it. They are using it. Now, the point is Cognizant. Assume that Cognizant hedge with a well-known bank in India, which is JP Morgan Chase India. They had hedge with a sub-account of JP Morgan Chase US, which is JP Morgan Chase India. Now the reason and the issue with we have with JP Morgan Chase India is that suppose they are taking a forward contract of $1 billion, suppose $500 million with JP Morgan Chase. Suppose the spot rate is 64, while the swaps is known as premium. 2-year premium is 6 rupees, so outright would be 70. And JP Morgan Chase is giving a outright of 70 to Cognizant Technologies. The job not yet ended here. Cognizant already have a CSA with JP Morgan Chase, and for that, the principal entity of the Cognizant, which is Cognizant US, always have some form of collateralization to JP Morgan Chase. But this collateralization would have two important things which we need to know. And I'm writing either this collateralization would have threshold, or this would have initial margin. Both threshold and initial margin are different from each other. What do you mean by threshold? JP Morgan Chase will tell to Cognizant that you can have the deal till $7 billion, notional amount is $7 billion with me. However, we will allow you either positive M2M of $3 billion or negative M2M of $4 billion. So if the M2M, mark to market gain on all the deals, and mark to market is L1, L2, L3 or L4, both, whether either L1, L2, L3 or L4, by the time it is between 3 billion plus 3 million plus 3 billion and minus 3 billion, there is nothing collateral which they have to give, or the E or the collateral which is submitted is not going to be refurnished. But when it is going to be cross that, when the minus 4 billion turned out to be minus 4.5 billion or minus 5 billion, or 3 billion turned out to be 3.5 billion or 4 billion, then they need to refurnish another collateralization, which is known as initial margin. that again in the CSA at a very same day, they need to specify that either it is in the form of cash, it is in the form of securities, it in the form of exotics, or if in the form of commodities. Commodities will surely not the case, because Cognizant is an IT company, so commodities is not the case. So cash is always the case because it is a free cash company. Sitting today, Cognizant have more than $3.5 billion of the free cash, which is lying in the asset side of their balance sheet, which means that $3.5 billion is of no use. It is just earning the minimum interest, because companies like Cognizant, companies like Cognizant, Apple, they're not very aggressive as far as the merger and acquisitions is concerned, right? Security wise, I don't think they have much exposure in the securities and exotics are concerned. But the issue starts from here after considering cash flow, fair value, net investment hedging, and the limit which you deciding. The issue is JP Morgan Chase will not keep that 70 rupees in the pocket. They will sell this in the interbank market. And assuming they have three interbank partners, which is Citibank, Standard Chartered Bank, and Goldman Sachs. Here is the word which is coming, which I told you in the earlier video, which is double side CSA. In this, what would happen, JP Morgan Chase, these are their interbank partners, and here is JP Morgan Chase India. And this is Indian entity, Citibank India, Standard Chartered India, Goldman Sachs India. Citibank India would have, all three would have three different CSA with JP Morgan Chase. With each other. So let me make this signal. They have three different CSAs with each other. In both the cases, JP Morgan Chase, example, we take an example of JP Morgan Chase and Standard Chartered. JP Morgan Chase would have, like, take an example of Standard Chartered and JP Morgan Chase India. They would have initial margin, requirement of initial margin, or they would have threshold. And it is a two-way collateral. This is not a one-way collateral. In case of the Cognizant to JP Morgan Chase, it was a one-way collateral. Here in the case of the interbank, it would be a two-way collateral. How it would be a two-way collateral? Standard Chartered Bank will give, let me write here, Standard Chartered Bank will give some collateral to JP Morgan Chase, which is, I am writing SCBC, Standard Chartered Bank collateral. JP Morgan Chase will give some collateral to Standard Chartered, which is JP Morgan C. Both will give some collateral to each other, and if the currency market is going very volatile in nature, and if they are ending up having negative mark to market, it would happen anytime, because Cognizant hedged with JP Morgan Chase, JP Morgan Chase assuming hedged with Citibank, Citibank hedged with HSBC, HSBC hedged with Deutsche. So that is a different fact. Standard Chartered Bank, one of them would have a negative mark to market. Either it is a JP Morgan Chase or it is a Standard Chartered Bank. Take an example. Cognizant sold for 70. JP Morgan Chase sold Cognizant to 70. It means Cognizant is a seller. Let me draw here. Cognizant is a seller of 70. JP Morgan Chase is a buyer at 70. Cognizant bought from Standard Chartered. Standard Chartered is a seller once again to JP Morgan. 70. Assuming 2 year outright, assuming there is no movement in the swaps, means the premium, but the one year, the spot rate has moved to 68, and the 1 year deal, 2 year deal turned out to be 74. It would be a loss for Cognizant. It would be a gain for JP Morgan. It would be a gain loss for Standard Chartered. This will end up negative mark to market in the books of Standard Chartered. This will end up positive mark to market in the books of JP Morgan Chase. It will end up negative mark to market in the books of Cognizant. Since they are in the interbank market, they can hedge this using options delta. That is a different part, which we are not discussing here. since they can hedge using option delta, so in either side, this would impact both the things. It will impact the threshold, that how much is the threshold of the negative mark to market. It would also impact the initial margin also. But that can only be possible provided you have a CSA agreement in place. CSA stands at Credit Support Annex. Without having a CSA agreement in place, this is next to impossible that they could have that. And CSA is one of the fantastic documentation. Of course, valuation is something which always an issue as far as the CSA is concerned. But using that, and especially in the interbank market, every bank would have a dedicated CSA with a different bank. And it is a double-sided CSA, which is the where sometimes it is a one-side collateral and another side which we have two-way collateral in place. So this is an example of Credit Support Annex Interbank CSA, which is a double-sided collateral, because JP Morgan Chase is the big bank. On the other hand side, Standard Chartered is also a big bank. So they will go with the double-sided collateral. We would like to thank you very much. And our website is www.treasuryconsulting.in. While my mobile is 9899242978. My email is rahul.magan@treasuryconsulting.in. Before winding up this video, I would like to tell you that we are doing a lot of training programs pertaining to foreign exchange, treasury, fixed income and all, and few of the training programs which we are also launching, which is structuring of derivatives and hardcore derivatives. These all you will find on our website, which is www.treasuryconsulting.in. And on this website, you would have one tab which is trainings. You can go there and you can have that. And more courses are coming. We are also launching the regulatory courses as well. Thank you and have a wonderful time.